Hey everyone, it's that time of year again. It's October, which means it's Shirktober time, which is kind of my twist on Inktober. In Inktober, you draw every day. In Shirktober, you create a t-shirt every day. And I have a special list for you of what to do every day. So there's different topics. And here's the list right here, all 31 days, each one with a different topic. And I'm gonna start with raccoon, and I'm gonna show you how I come up with a raccoon t-shirt in this video. So I'm gonna go step by step on different things that I'm gonna use. I'm gonna use Nano Banana and try and do a raccoon vintage illustration t-shirt using that, and kind of show you the process that I'm going through, because I did so well in my other video, if you saw that one right here with the goose. So I wanna see if it can do a raccoon, and vintage raccoons are doing really well right now, so I thought I'd put it in. And by the way, this list that I made for Shirktober is kind of all the different topics that are evergreen, so hopefully these not only sell during Q4, they should help you get sales throughout the year too. So that's the idea, is to have these topics to help you get some sales during the year, and that's the plan. So in this video, I'm gonna take this sketch right here of my raccoon, run it through Nano Banana, and see what happens. So if you wanna follow along, you can find this list on my channel and Detour Shirts. I'll put it right there. It's also all over social media. You don't have to do it every day if you don't want to, but you can have fun and just have a list of topics and hopefully get some sales with it as well. So the first thing we're gonna do is take this sketch that I made of this raccoon and run it through Nano Banana and see what it comes up with. All right, so here I am on Google Gemini 2.5 Flash Nano Banana. I have the image thing here, I believe. Does it say Nano Banana here? It doesn't, but it's the Flash version. But this is the one that I'm using. I have the tools, create images down there, great. I'm gonna add my scan that I do right here, scan JPEG. And then I already wrote a prompt, so I'm gonna copy this prompt that I have on the side here, and I'm gonna put it here. So basically it's saying use this sketch as a reference to create this image. I made sure that it's vintage illustration line art style. I kind of talked about what the raccoon should be doing and what it should look like, and that it's only going to be two colors and so on. So I'm going to hit this, and hopefully it takes this idea, and the raccoon's holding a wine glass right here, and it's all in the right style, and I don't have to do anything, crossing fingers that it does it right. Not bad. I probably could do that. I'm going to try and run it again and do it. Wonder if I can make it in a different style. Let's try something else. All right, I'm gonna try a different style here. I said nice, but can you do it in a vintage illustration hand-drawn engraved style? So I'm trying to make it even more elegant, and let's see what happens. I'm gonna do that here, and I think maybe I need to upload a version of the style and have it tell me what style it is and then do it in that style, but it just did the same thing over it again. So I think it could work. It's not as nice of a style that I was hoping for, and I wonder if I don't use it as a reference and see what happens. So I'm gonna, one more time, I'm gonna start a new chat and not use the reference. I'm gonna type this in, have it all on a solid white background. There should only be two colors. Two colors, dark blue and white. All right, let's see what happens. If not, I'll just use the same one, but maybe it's gonna come up with something that I actually like. Oh, yes, that is pretty cool. I like that. But I don't want the coat, but that's the style that I wanted, and I didn't want the words. So I wonder if I can come in here and say remove the coat. I can remove the words pretty easy, so I think that one's pretty cool. Let's see if it does it. I like that style a lot better. If it just removes the coat and adds sunglasses to that. I haven't removed the coat and the vest and the tie, but that's kind of cool. Oh, and it should have a bushy tail, because I think in this case it didn't have a tail. Okay, I'm gonna try one more thing. With AI, you gotta get it right. prompt it right. All right, so I wrote, remove the vest and tie, but add a bushy tail. Let's see if it does it. Oh my gosh, it keeps wanting to add a shirt to it. All right, one last time. I don't want the raccoon wearing clothes and make the tail up and bigger. Let's see. Perfect, that's what I wanted. I think that turned out really good and I can remove that. So next steps is I'm gonna have to vectorize this and then put some text. I don't want it to say raccoons reserve. I want it to say classy, not trashy. So next thing I'm gonna do is take this, I'm gonna download it and then bring this into Vexels and vectorize it. All right, so this step should be pretty quick. I'm in Vexels, designer.vexels.com, and the designer app within Vexels, and I really love it for vectorizing. So I'm gonna grab my design here, drag it in. Oh, that's not how you do it. I think you go here, upload the graphics, whoops. Choose a file to upload, and then my download right here. Okay, and there it is. Boom, clicking on this, we'll put it here. And now, so you don't just drag it, you have to click to upload. And then I'm gonna vectorize, which isn't bad, five tokens. And it does a really good job too. So I'm only gonna need one color. Boom. It does multicolor one, but in this case, I only want one color. I'm gonna vectorize the image and let's see what it does. It should just do it black and white, which is great because when I bring it into something like Affinity Designer, I should be able to color it whatever color I want, and I can make it dark blue or brown or whatever. Great. Okay, I think that still looks good. And now that it's done, I can download and I can do SVG format and transparent background, sure, and download. All right, so I'm gonna take this here, the download, the SVG, bring it into Affinity Designer, add the words classy, not trashy, and I'll be done. All right, so here it is. I brought it into, it's a SVG, so you can see it's all the colors here. So I think I can just get rid of I'll double click on this. Yeah, there you go. I'll get rid of that. Let's make sure that it's really transparent. So I'm gonna put a color behind it. Oh, we're seeing some white here. So let's get rid of some of this. I'm gonna double click on the white. Oh no, that is not what I wanted. I only wanted one color. Well, there's one way around this. I can take all the white and I can knock it out of the dark one. So first, I'm gonna take all these that I don't want here. And I don't need that or that. All right, so on the side here, let me show you if this happens to you. You can kind of group all the white ones. And hopefully they're not at the top. All right, so here's the, let's see what we got here. I may be able to just remove those. Let's see. Yeah, I think that did okay. Then I got this white one here. That seemed to not do anything. And then I got all these white ones here, which looks like it does do something. So check out all the white. Wow. It usually does a really good job, but I guess for this presentation doesn't, which gives me a good chance for you to see how to knock this out. Hopefully it works. So I'm gonna go through all of this white right here. There's a ton of it. And I'm gonna do all of that. I'm gonna group it. There it is. And if I turned it off, yeah, that's all the white. So I'm gonna group everything below it like that. I'll group that. And then I'm gonna put these two together and group them together like that. And then I'm gonna open up the white one here and I'll just say erase. Ta-da, fixed it. All right, so now that we got that out of the way, I need to do something that says classy, not trashy. So maybe I want like a cursive font, so I'm gonna move myself back here. And let's see, I'll do the text tool here in Affinity Designer and classy like that. And I wanted to see like a classy font. That actually might not be too bad, but let me see. I got some fun favorites here, like some script fonts here. Those are kind of classy. That's actually really classy. I wonder if this works with the Y coming down like that over his head, or maybe the hard thing is it's nice and tall, but we don't need any more height. We need width for this t-shirt. So I'm kind of wanting to like maybe cover him something. Let me do not trashy anyway here. I'll do another one, text. All right. Oh, there you go. I don't know why this one doesn't have a... Oh, there it is. I just couldn't see it. So classy, maybe classy like that. And then that's too hard to read for not trashy. So I'm gonna do more of a longer, I want a wider one. For it, but still kind of look classy here. Let me move this so you can see what I'm doing. And maybe I'm turning this too much. And I think if we could do classy right here and maybe cut him off, we don't need to see his feet. Maybe that could be okay. All right. So one thing I'm gonna do is make this a white background, so it's the blues we don't need right now. And we'll do this the same color as that. And we'll put an outline in the background like this. So I have another one in the back. It has an outline right here. And then we'll make the stroke a lot bigger. Yeah, that could work. And then maybe not trashy. Somewhere like that, but we're gonna have to cover this here. So let me do like a white here. And kind of covering it. There we go. Classy, not trashy, put this in the front. I wonder if we, this time I don't need it white. If I want to put it under here, I might have to change this font to something tall. And I like using veneer. I might as well use it because it's one of my favorites and it kind of has that vintage feel. And it's definitely condense. So let's make sure we have that blue that we're using everywhere. That doesn't look like the right color. There we go. Classy, not trashy. I know. I think that kind of works. Maybe we need the raccoon a little bigger. You know. Yeah. Works and not trashy, smaller. Just playing around with size here. Maybe this even turns a little bit. All right, what do you guys think of that? I think that could work on a t-shirt. Make it bigger like that. So the one thing I need to do now is I need to like knock these things out that I put on here. So So this whole thing is going to be a group, and then I'm going to group these white ones here, group, and then I'm going to group all these together, group, and then I'm going to erase this right here. And so when I do that, that whole background you can see is knocked out. So this will look fine on a pink shirt or on a light blue shirt. We don't have any white on there. So there you go. I think that turned out okay. It didn't do the sketch that I wanted to, but I think running it again, it kind of knew what I was doing, what I wanted, because from before. And this is just a much better style than the other one that I came up with the illustration. So pretty cool. I'm happy with it. And I'm going to go with this as my t-shirt for Shirtober day one. So there you go. That was day one of Shirtober, my raccoon design. Hopefully you found that helpful. I'll try and do more design tutorials on this channel about it. I don't know if I'll be able to do all 31 days, but be on the lookout for more design tutorials on different days on Shirtober. Hopefully this was really helpful for you. And if you want to see another design video that I did, I'll put my latest one right here so you can follow along and help create even more designs for you to make sales in Q4. And as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.